Come on, praise the Lord, everybody. First off, I want to invite any clergy that are here to please come and join us if you would like. If not, it says a celebration of life.
All right.
I've never been to a celebration where there was quietness.
Amen.
I need 2 years. Let me say that again. 92 years. You know, younger people often say to us, older people, I couldn't handle what you went through. Ain't no way I could have did it back then. Well, let me just say to you young people, 92 years. Somebody catch it after a while. 92 years. And I can guarantee every day with roses. Everything went cream. Somewhere in there, God had to intervene and 92 years. I don't know why she was saying about 92 years. She gave God a life and a young man. I don't know how young she was, but I can guarantee you, in 92 years. I'm not even going to talk about the whole 92 years. I can guarantee you in the last 92 days, she called it in the car. But every time I saw her, she had that lovely smile on her face. It's hard for you to go through something and run into somebody who's such a believer that they always got a smile on their face. 92 years. Stand.
Friends, loved ones, and neighbors. Those who knew this mother over the years,
But let them to know that even though the world was deep above, Mother, your love reaches beyond all understanding, all faith. Call them in your ever-loving arms. Draw them closer together, that they would recognize that you is the Almighty God. When it's time to leave, it's you that are of now. Yes. But we say thank you for the life that we shared with those that among us who have passed on. Well, but for this family, grant him to know now that Mother is gone on home. Yes. One day we all must take that trip out. Yes. Yes. Help our hearts and our spirit to be prepared. As we travel through life's journey, or shine through us the light of glory that somebody might see, that you still have your hand outreached and come. But when it's time that we must leave this way, let not our labor be in vain. But I pray that you come that I might be able to lay my hand on your breast, to breathe my life away into your hand. Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. Come on, somebody give God a hand of praise. Yes. Right now, the program calls for a selection from the Apostolic Faith Grace Ministries Choir. And immediately after that, we'll have the scriptures. We have the Old Testament by Minister Tony Holmes, the New Testament by Minister Tilden Copeland. Amen.
Amen. remember me.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Oh, Lord.
Yes, sir.
Remember me. Haven't been to church all my life. I know you knew me then. But right now, Lord, remember me. And when I say remember me, I'm talking about all my genealogy. That have visions and dreams.
All right.
The ones that called on God in the midnight hour. The ones that plow fields for other people. The ones that tread through the lifetime. My God, remember me. Amen. We're here to celebrate life. Amen. We're coming out of Psalms 23rd. The Lord is my shepherd. I shall not want. He maketh me to lie down in the green pastures. He leadeth me beside the still waters. He restored my soul. He leadeth me in the path of righteousness for his name's sake. Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil. For thou art with me, thy rod and thy staff, thy comfort me. Thou preparest a table before me in the presence of my enemies. Thou anointest my head with oil, my cup running over. Surely you'll remember me. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever. God the word for God and people.
Amen.
Church.
Morning.
Praise God, praise God. Amen. Thank God. Here to celebrate Mother Lily Mae Wells.
Yeah.
I'm her great nephew.
All right.
Thank God for her. I'm Elder Toby Coleman.
All right.
I thank God for that. Yeah. God has blessed her. We call her Aunt Lily.
Yeah.
Amen. And in her last days, sitting there in the hospital, going through rehab, and finally at Hope Hospice. Y'all know that one saying that I ain't really used to say. Like devil man can't. she was in that hospital writing with pain. You asked her how she was feeling, she would give you that same answer. Fine and dandy, like devil man can't. I just praise God. She truly was an inspiration to us all, the family. And I just praise God for that. And as I read the scripture here today, I'm coming from John the 11th chapter, and starting at the 20th verse, it says, "Then Martha, as soon as she heard that Jesus was coming, went to meet him. But Mary sat still in the house. Then said Martha to Jesus, Lord, if thou hadst been here, my brother would not have died. But I know that even now, whatsoever thou likest of God, God will give it thee. Jesus said unto her, thy brother shall rise again.
Yes.
Oh, yes.
Yes.
Martha says unto him, I know that he shall rise again in the resurrection at the last day. Jesus said unto her, I am the resurrection and the life. And he that believeth in me, though he were dead, yet shall he live.
Stir you up.
as a believer, you should never. Somebody catch that later on. When you're riding down the road and you're going through something and everybody's saying this and everybody's saying that, you're going to think about that one word, never. Can he win? Never. Will this last forever? Never. I'm going to keep my composure. I got manners. I'm going to keep my composure. But there's something about the Holy Ghost. Sometimes when I'm alone by myself right now in the morning, or through my mistake, and I don't feel the thing like I'm overcome, and I don't know.
today to help me again. Because the word I had yesterday was for yesterday. But a meeting word to suffice me today. So there's another enemy going to attack today. So I need to know the strategy that God has for me to be able to succeed today.
Thank you, God.
Tammy has put on the program, please limit to 2 minutes. So if you got something you want to say, now is your time.
Good morning.
Thank you.
brothers, to all my family, even all my great aunts. Amen. As my brother spoke earlier, when you see her, even if she's in pain, you will never know it. And the biggest thing, I tease her with the doctor, and everything, I'm going this way, I said, I ain't gonna tell her. I'm fine and dead, and like, couple of me, you know, but Aunt Lily, truly, a mentor and a mother to us when we lost our mother. Aunt Lily stood in the face of my grandmother when she passed. When I went to nursing school, my grandmother had died. Aunt Lily said, baby, don't worry about it. I'm scared of the face of the world. So those are the great members that were always stay with me, because she was always by my side. Aunt Lily is very special to me because of Nate Allen. So she's very dear to me.
Yes.
It's heavy. The day where she transitioned, as I was talking to her, like she was trying to talk back to me. And I told her to relax. I know you're here. And you're trying to make a sound. I said, I'm okay. I said, so if you're holding on to me, I'm okay. You're tired. But thank God, as the pastor said, the woman has to live to number 2. Every day, it wasn't grand for her. But when she became a child of God, she was able to be pure, whatever came from her. I'm supposed to say, she don't have to be in your program. But at the end comes, she's going to bring a song. And as I was at the wake the other day, one of the sisters came back and said, and remember, a man is there. She had to fight for the devil.
She had to, because she
she wanted to share something that she had been through for a long time. That song, if we think about the words of the song that she used to sing, we all are in that tussle. Mother said, the devil and I had a tussle, but guess what? She won. Family, I know y'all hearts are heavy and you're a little sad right now. But kingdom is happy because of another soldier. A soldier, a real soldier, a fighter. So even though she might not be here in the flesh, the memories that she left will never, ever go away. Because no matter where Reverend Kelly goes, no matter what he do, he got a whole bunch of talking he can remember her by driving down the road. And every one of us got that same memory of mother that we can hold on to. Right now it calls for a special tribute by the Spiritual Voices.
Thank you. church say amen.
Amen.
Resolutions. Beloved memory of Miss Lillian Warren. Let not your heart be troubled. You believe in God, believe also in me that in my Father's house are many mansions. If it were not so, I would have told you. I go to prepare a place for you, and if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again and receive you unto myself. And where I am, there you may be also. John 14:1-3. We, the members of Full Gospel Pentecost Missionary Baptist Church, want the family to know that our hearts are with you as we gather to bid a Christian goodbye to Miss Lily Mae Warren. Whereas the passing of Miss Lily Mae Warren has left us deeply saddened, she will be missed, but never forgotten. Whereas the passing of our loved one is the will of God, and there is a human tie that has been broken, we are encouraged and consoled in the words of Jesus who said, I will never leave thee nor forsake thee. Hebrews 13:5. Therefore, be it resolved that Miss Lily Mae Warren has left this life, but not our hearts. And be it further resolved that a copy of this resolution has been given to the family, and a copy will be kept in the church archives. To the family, we know that your loss is deep and your sorrow is great. But we want you to know that we share in your sorrow. Humbly submitted on this day, 29th day of July 2023, the pastor and members of Full Gospel Pentecost Missionary Baptist Church, Pastor Troy Willie Green. Now sit tight as a couple of Bartow District Church of God in Christ, Florida, Eastern Ecclesiastical Jurisdiction. And God shall wipe away all the tears from their eyes, and there shall be no more death, neither sorrow nor crying, neither shall there be any more pain, for the former things are passed away. Revelations 21:4. The angel of death has visited us and taken from our midst Mother Lily Mae Warren. We pause here today to pay our last respect to our dearly departed church mother, sister, aunt, songster, and friend. We are living in a world where shadows are continually falling upon our pathway, shadows that teach us insecurity of all temporal blessings and warn us that here there is no rest for the weary. Whereas the death of Mother Lily Mae Warren emphasizes that none is superior to that last call, which is common to all beings, we are reminded that the way of each of us leads through the grave. Whereas Mother Lily Mae Warren was a well-known icon in our community, where she enjoyed singing "The Devil and I Had a Tussle, and I Won." She exemplified a humble spirit and a contagious smile each time she visited our church. Whereas the passing of Mother Lily Mae Warren is the will of God, there is a human tie that has been broken that bleeds the heart of agony and pain in our lives. We shall always remember her cheerful smile and her harmonious voice as she sang with the spiritual voices. Whereas you will find comfort and consolation in the words of the Apostle Peter, who said, cast your burden upon him because he cares for you, 1 Peter 5:7. God saw and he knows, therefore we commend you to him who will comfort, cheer, dry your eyes, and heal your broken heart if you will put your unwavering faith in him. Be it resolved that you continue making God your hope, and that you look up to him, up to the hills, for which cometh your help. May God continue to bless you, give you strength and courage. Be it resolved that we embrace this bereaved family in our common bond of grief and remembrance of a church mother, sister, aunt, songster, and friend. Precious in the sight of the Lord is the death of his saints, Psalm 116:15. Be it further resolved that a copy of this resolution be given to the family and a copy kept on record in the church archives. Humbly submitted on this 29th day of our Lord, July 2023, the officers and members of the Bartow District Church of God in Christ, Florida Ecclesiastical Jurisdiction. Amen. Friendship, Mr. Missionary Baptist Church, 2500 Lucerne Park Road in Winter Haven, Florida. Reverend Arthur J. Salary, Senior, resolution on July 29, 2023. Again, a human spirit has taken its flight at the call of the Heavenly Father to the mansion prepared for her from the foundation of the earth by an all-wise and loving God. We end these resolutions to express our sympathy to the family of Sister Lily Warren. Friendship Missionary Baptist Church rejoices that her belief in the promise of God in Psalm 73 and 24 has now fulfilled. Thou shalt guide me with thy counsel and afterward receive me to glory. Her daily life gave evidence of the fact that she believed God's word and followed his guidance, seeking his leadership in all she said and did. She was upright, loving, kind in all her ways, sincere and genuine in all of her doings. She has left behind a beautiful memory, and we pray that others may emulate her life. Friendship Missionary Baptist Church expresses our deep sympathy to Sister Annie Birdsong and family. Our prayer is that you rely on comfort upon the gracious Lord of heaven and earth. Resolve that we will ever cherish her memory and look forward with joy to meeting her in the home which she knew for so many years was being prepared for her in glory land. Precious in the sight of our Lord is the death of his saints. For whether we live unto the Lord, and whether we die unto the Lord. Whether we live, therefore, or die, we are the Lord's. Humbly submitted, Reverend Arthur J. Salary, Pastor, Sister Dorothy J. Earl, Secretary. That's been not easy. First Missionary Baptist Church, Reverend Clifton E. Dawson, pastor and teacher. July 29, 2023, resolution. God walking in his garden, one he made with his own hands. The sun was shining down on each blossom, young and old throughout the land. In our midst, he walked still searching. Passing here, he found one ready to be taken in that hour. We are placed in this world for a limited time, and with the breath of an infant begin the race to the grave. Whereas the providence of God, he has ended the life of Sister Lily Warren, the pastor, officers, and disciples of First Missionary Baptist Church feel that it is befitting to express our sympathy to our members, Brother Nathaniel and Sister Ann Birdsong and family. Whereas it is with sad feeling we record the passing of Sister Warren, we commend you to him who knoweth best and will do right. For you have our prayers and our deepest sympathy during your time of bereavement, because the earth has no sorrow that heaven cannot heal. Humbly submitted, Reverend Clifton J. Dawson, pastor, teacher, and Laura Robinson, the clerk. God bless you.
I have finished now with this house of faith. Please carefully and gently make your way, and let me rest from this life of pain, toiling in sunshine, storm, and rain. Many times I was misunderstood when I had done the best that I could. I am tired now, so let me rest. Please, no sad heart, no one down here. He's saying, do not weep for me, for I am not dead. I have another house to go, where only God redeemed can go. So I do not need this house of faith. So please carefully and gently make it away. We, the management and staff of James C. Ford Chiron, on behalf of Mother Lily, we thank you all for coming out today and supporting them at this time. Your cards, your letters, your government full arrangements will not be personal at this time, but you all will be thanked in a more personal manner at a more opportune time. May God bless and strengthen your entire prayer and all of the prayers of the family. Again, we say God bless you.
Amen. Amen.
I told Reggie this. I said, Reggie, let me tell you something. If there's anything in this world that I could do for my Lord, I'm gonna do it. Can't no devil in hell separate the relationship and the love that I had in my heart for my Lord. So if it's okay with the church this month, I just want y'all to give God a thank you.
Yeah. she walked in the church one Sunday and tears.
If it's anything,
never seen the right thing. Oh, sleep, they breathe. Whatever it is you need, God got it. Whatever you want, God got it. I stopped by to tell you the mother warned. Her life speaks for her. But I won with him today. Will there be love? Let the same be said for. Let the life that you live speak for you. Don't let your work be evil spoken of. Whatever you do, do it in the name of the Lord, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Ghost. And whatever you do, do it to try to make a difference in somebody's life.
Yes, sir.
God is a good God. God is a good God. Like the preacher said earlier, everybody ain't always been saved. So it's okay if you put your Holy Ghost behavior to the side for a bit and just remember what God has brought you. That I'm ashamed of because I enjoyed doing it when I was doing it. But I thank God for praying on. Thank God. God has enabled me to be able to stand and talk to people and try to make a difference in somebody else's life. Because she stopped one day in front of my house. She said, "Pastor, you come in." She said, "I want to tell you something." I said, "Yeah." She said, "I want you to know that God told me to tell you that the reason he let you build this house, where it's at." Now, everybody know Henderson Avenue, I'm right down from the number one spot. Say no more. But she said, "God told me to tell you, he allowed you to build that house there because you are a sign to other people to let them know that if he can do it for you, he'll do it for them." That's trying to make a difference in somebody's life. God saved all of us. Us making a difference in somebody's life. All of our black kids are gone.
Amen.
All of our little brothers and sisters are not lost. There are still some good black brothers and sisters out there in this world. There are still some black people going into the NBA. There are still some black people going into the NFL. There are still some black kids that's going into Grambling College and all of them. Don't give up on
them.
Make a difference in their life. The Bible says, "Go into the vineyard and work. Whatever is right, I'll pay. The harvest is plenty, but the labors are few. Let us go into the vineyard. That maybe somebody will hear a word that will make a difference, like one woman in somebody's life. Family, don't keep you here. Keep looking to God. God is able. children. They say, yeah, yeah. They'll call me, you know. This telephone call away. Billy, they'll be your way back. And all you have to do is stop by and give them a call if there's anything happening to them. I will. Amen.
Thank you.